This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. We're here in South Florida, actually West Palm Beach, and actually I'm standing on some sand, go figure. But nonetheless, today we've got a special episode for you. We're here at Southern J Ranch, and this is at the entrance, just the gates, you know, kind of off a residential area. But this is a 5-acre property where they're growing food and also have a nursery. So let's go inside and see what's growing on. All right, so here we are in the papaya orchard here at Southern J Ranch in West Palm Beach, Florida. Whenever I travel, I like to check Local Harvest. It's a website where I find local growers of fruits and vegetables so that I can eat the freshest stuff. Then many times I'll maybe even get to make an episode for you guys like this one today. I'm so excited that I'm making an episode because this place is super uber cool and I like it a lot. So besides just growing the papayas commercially, and you can see here, here's a one papaya up and another one just fell, that these guys are called Mardole papayas. Now you can buy papayas probably at your local grocery store, imported probably from the Caribbean or Mexico, but let me tell you, you haven't tasted a papaya till you got one fresh, and especially if it's like fresh picked right off the tree. I mean, you know they're good when there's little spots in it like this and the birds are eating them. Actually, these are the best ones. What I'd like to do is cut out the bad parts and eat the rest, because guess what? Birds and nature knows when the fruit's the ripest and it's gonna taste the best. So I'm literally buying a whole case of papayas here today, but besides just selling the fruit, papayas and actually muscadines, which we'll look in a minute, they also have a nursery here where they sell baby plants, and they have some unique ones that we're gonna look at today. So let's continue on my journey, show you some muscadines and show you some of those cool plants and actually seeds that they're offering, including an heirloom tomato that I know you've been looking for, especially if you live in South Florida. Here's yet another crop they're growing. Now these guys aren't quite in season right now. This is the muscadine grape. So the muscadine grape grows really well in the South. And you can see it here. There's some nice large grapes, nowhere near ripe, and they got all these nice leaves. Now the muscadine grape is the grape you should be growing if you're in the South. Don't be growing the common grapes they grow in California if you're in the South. You want to grow these guys. So I always encourage you to grow climate appropriate plants. So if you live in the South or South Florida, you definitely want to pick up some of these muscadines. Actually, what we're going to do next is actually go over to the nursery, and I'm going to show you some of the plants they're offering here at Southern J Ranch. Now we're in the nursery area here at Southern J Ranch, and this is where they have the trees, the papaya trees for sale. So you just saw me over at the big trees that they're actually selling the fruit off of. And once again, these are Mardole papayas. So these are the large style papayas. And actually they're some of my favorite, and the Mardole papayas are not genetically modified in Hawaii, and they are genetically modifying some papayas. So you must be really careful when purchasing papayas from Hawaii. So I only encourage you to purchase the Mardoles, or actually better yet, grow your own if you're here in South Florida. And all these plants look amazing. These are in 3-gallon pots. I mean, there's a whole bunch of them here, and they even sell to commercial growers. So somebody will come in and like wipe out rows of crops to take and grow in their orchard so that they can sell you the fruit later on. So you can buy where the big boys buy, but they also sell direct to the public. And I have to say, these are some of the best prices that I've seen in South Florida for the papayas. I mean, this is the cheapest price that you will probably find anywhere in South Florida, and I could definitely vouch that these plants are super healthy. Next, let's take a look at some of the other fruit trees that they're offering. Now what we're looking at are one of my favorite fruits to grow in South Florida. The main reason why is because this is a plant that puts out all year long. Many fruit trees like mangoes may only produce a crop one time a year, and the star fruit here produces or puts out multiple times a year. So I definitely like fruit trees that put out, and I like girls that also put out a lot more times than one time a year too. In any case, this is the cheapest price I've ever seen on star fruit trees, especially in a 1-gallon pot. I mean, I don't even know why these are still here. So if you guys live in South Florida, highly encourage you to come down and relieve him of some of his star fruit trees. In addition, behind me there, he's got some dragon fruit, and man, this is like probably one of the most economical places you could buy your fruit trees if he has it. I mean, this is like, he sells usually wholesale, but he also sells like wholesale prices to the public. Literally, it's amazing. So dragon fruits, once again, right behind me. Now dragon fruits, you may need several varieties for it to pollinate properly. Nonetheless, we're gonna go and take a look at actually the one of the world's hottest peppers, called the ghost pepper. Now we're in the section of the nursery that has all the Bujolokia plants, or the ghost peppers are called ghost met peppers in American because most people can't pronounce Bujolokia, Bujolokia, Bujolokia. Say that 5 times pretty quick. That'll be a fun tongue twister. But in any case, they have the small ones. They just started right here. And these guys are nice and lush. And you might be saying, hey John, how come that one in the 3 gallon doesn't look so good? Well, this is a mature plant. This guy has been growing for 9 months and endured like a freeze here in South Florida. That's pretty rare actually. Well, maybe not so rare. And also tomato hornworm. So the hornworm devastated the leaves. The freeze got a couple of leaves, but it's still producing. And you must think I'm crazy if you think I'm gonna pick one of these and eat it, because man, I'll be in pain. So I'd highly encourage you to pick these and eat them straight. You gotta mix them up in something, or maybe just have a little bit. This is the world's hottest pepper. These are from India, and what they do in India, the farmers line the top of their fence with them so that the elephants don't come in. And even the police in India, I heard, is making pepper spray out of this stuff, because man, you will be in pain. I don't know why anybody would want to grow these world's hottest peppers, but if you do, they have them here, and the price for a 1 gallon, and they do use recycled pots here, so they're environmentally friendly, and occasionally they bust up a little bit, but that's all right. The price for a 1 gallon pot is cheaper than a 4-inch pepper plant in California. So that's, you get wholesale direct prices to the public. I love to do shots of when I get to lay down on the job, and here's a time for you guys. So now I'm laying down, and you know, once again, this is a professional place here. They got drip irrigation to basically water all their plants. They got some sandy soil here and root nematodes in the ground, so they decided to grow in pots, and that's probably a really good idea. And this is how they raise the Bujolokias, or the ghost peppers, to harvest so that they can sell you the seeds, the dried fruits whole, and also the powder. But the thing that was really cool that I never saw anybody before, and it takes a good smart Southern boy to do this, because most people would just go to the store and buy the little stakes you'd put the drippers on so that they'd stay in the pot. He just like, oh, I got these, I just gotta pop a hole in there and leave it and put the emitter in there, and then they ain't going nowhere. So I thought that was real cool, and I want to show you guys that before I show you the ripe Bujolokias that are almost ready for harvesting and how they should look if you're growing them. Next, we're going to share with you how you can tell if your Bujolokia pepper, or any pepper for that matter, is ripe. So the easy explanation is that your pepper is ripe when you want it to be ripe. If it's your plant, you get to choose when to harvest it. Now, whether it's true ripe or not, that's another story. So as you can see, most peppers are first green and then they turn another color when they're finally ripe, and they may go through shades of color. So these Bujolokias start off as like a green, and then they turn like this shade. It's a little shade off green. Then they get to this color, and this is a nice looking Bujolokia. Now this could go maybe a shade darker, but the skin gets a little bit wrinkled and it's nice and dark. Actually, they would harvest this guy right now for seed. These seeds are definitely mature, but I like to harvest all my peppers as ripe as possible. I have other videos on YouTube where I describe this more in detail. Nonetheless, this is the very pepper that they're gonna harvest and then dry the seeds, and they will send the seeds to you. So stay tuned to the end of this video for the contact information so that you can order your Bujolokia seeds, the ghost pepper seeds, and grow them yourself, because they do not ship the plants. They also do ship the whole dried peppers. So if you got a smart aleck kid that thinks he could eat anything, you gotta order one of these dried peppers and he won't think that no more. Or if you're in a fraternity, give these to your fraternity brothers. Oh yeah, here's the world's hottest pepper. Prove to me you're a man. Have them eat it. And yeah, then I think they'll be about this big after they eat that. But nonetheless, the other way they sell besides the whole dried pod is in the powder form. And if you want to have the world's hottest pepper, I would encourage you to grow them and make powder, or just buy the powder pre-made, because you can dose out just a small bit, like maybe like a couple grains, and that's going to be enough pepper to definitely spice up all your food. In this area of the nursery, what he has growing is the Everglades tomato. So the Everglades tomato is a tomato that grows actually really well here in South Florida. If you're gonna grow one variety of tomato, I would highly encourage you to grow the Everglades tomato. And we're gonna talk more about the Everglades in just a second. But the Everglades here are in just 1 gallon, and you can see, I mean, these plants are not even that big in a 1 gallon. You can see this thing's already setting fruit on there. It's totally amazing, and the prices here, like I said, wholesale to the public. I mean, for the price he's charging for this whole thing, I could buy a 4-inch back in California. And he has a whole bunch of plants. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to go around his yard. I'm going to show you why you want to purchase this Everglades tomato, because it is naturalized here in South Florida. It's probably been growing for hundreds of years. They don't even know where it come from. Maybe even the Spaniards brought it over with the pigs and the cows and the cattle or something, but whatever. It's naturalized here, and this is a fairly disease and bug resistant variety because, you know, it's been growing here naturally. And so we want to get back to growing heirloom crops such as the Everglades tomato instead of other ones that are maybe grown to be bounced on the ground and still look good. Let me tell you, these guys taste really good, and taste, in my opinion, is what it's all about. This is why you want to get that Everglades tomato. I mean, this area is just like the sand. I mean, we are here in West Palm Beach. I mean, this is the beach and this is the sand. And you can see here, here's a weed coming up from the sand. But look what's next door to the weed. This is an Everglades tomato coming up as a weed. I mean, food crops that grow as weeds are the ones you want to grow, because you don't got to do nothing to them. They just grow as a weed. So without even much care, these guys are going to come up and grow lots of food for you guys. So you guys don't even got to think about gardening, and that's the best way to garden. We're next to the shade house where they start many of the crops here, and check it out. Growing amongst the grass, once again coming up as a weed, is this damn Everglades tomato. I mean, check it out, it's just so huge, and they just close this door on it and all kinds of stuff. It gets abused, stepped on, but it's still growing. This is the tomato plant that you literally can't get rid of if you live in South Florida. And you know what? That's a good one to grow, in my opinion. Reason number one for growing the Everglades tomato is because it grows like a weed. Reason number two is because it's so prolific. Check it out. We just showed you the little baby weed coming up, but this thing's been growing definitely a long time, and there's probably about a dozen plants in this area. I mean, check it out. We can lift some of these up. This thing is just loaded with the Everglades small little like currant sized tomato. Let me go ahead and take the camera off the tripod and show you guys like how much massive quantity of fruit is produced right here.
Here it is. Check it out. This big whole patch. I mean, there's probably about a dozen plants here. And you know what? They just let this sprawl. They don't trim it. They don't do nothing. This is just wild grown Everglades tomato. And we could just go into the heart here, the tomato bush. I mean, you can see there's all these fruits that are ripening them up. And you know what? Let me tell you guys, I've had some of these just a little bit earlier. These guys are super sweet. Man, that's a good, that's one of the best tomatoes I've ever had. Now what these tomatoes lack in size, they definitely make up in taste. And look, all these green unripe tomatoes, these are just gonna be ripening them up. If you just have a few plants, you could provide food for your whole family, like enough for a salad every night. Easy, no problem whatsoever. Man, I can't stop eating these guys. I think they had some wind damage or something over here. But take a look, once the foliage got defoliated, you could really see all the fruit on there, man. Load it up. This thing just grows so prolifically down here in South Florida.
Reason number three why I like the Everglades tomato is because you can dry farm them. As you just saw the weed coming up, this plant right here basically has the water turned off. There's nothing in this air of the nursery right now, so the water's turned off. This is not getting watered, but check it out, it's still growing. So once you get it established, as long as it's, you know, raining at least occasionally, the plant will spread out its roots to find its water. And I would also encourage you to use mycorrhiza, which will make your plants more drought resistant. It's been shown in studies, I think 30% more drought resistant by using mycorrhiza. If you don't know about mycorrhiza, be sure to check my other episodes. I have a few good episodes on mycorrhiza. It definitely worked well in my garden. My tomato plants exploded growth, and like so much I couldn't even control them. But anyways, these guys can be trellised, but you know what? I would just let them sprawl out if you have the room. When buying seeds of the Everglades tomato, you have to be careful because these do cross-pollinate. So tomatoes cross-pollinate and can breed with other tomato seeds. And that's one of the things they do here at the Southern J Ranch. They only grow the Everglades tomato, and they only grow the Bouchalokia pepper. So you're gonna be assured you're getting true seeds that are gonna make the plants you want. And the true Everglades tomato is drought resistant, fairly disease resistant, and it grows year round here in South Florida. They've been growing it for 2.5 years. They produce in the summertime. It's an amazing crop. If you live in the north, it's probably not gonna grow year round for you. So you're gonna have to just grow them every season and save your seeds. But let me tell you, these guys taste amazing and they're fairly disease resistant. So next we're gonna get to talk with the owner, Ed, and he's gonna share more with us about the Everglades tomato and where he's grown them. Actually, vertically. We're here now with Ed, and he's the owner of the property here and grows all this stuff so that you guys can grow some food at home. And here's just one of the Everglades tomato. He's growing in one of those PVC tubes that actually he put together. It might be like kind of like the ones in the last episode you might have saw. And this isn't even growing out the holes. It's growing out the top because he was telling me this is growing as a weed. So you can even grow them vertically. I think it hangs down really nice and it makes the fruit really easy to harvest. So we're gonna ask Ed a few questions about how he got into growing these Everglades tomato and why he's growing them. So Ed, why did you get into growing these Everglades tomatoes?
Well, we learned about them about 5 years ago. And I'm a third generation Floridian and spent a lot of time in the Everglades and never knew we had a wild native Florida tomato. And we're really Florida lovers. Like to always grow and raise stuff that's native to Florida. It grows better. Our heat down here in the summer is just atrocious with the humidity and stuff. And we just, the less care that a plant, you know, has down here, water and all that, the better.
Wow, that's great. I would definitely encourage you wherever you live, if you live in Florida and you're growing tomatoes, you gotta get these guys. If you're growing somewhere else, you wanna grow native edible crops whenever possible. So you can see this thing is so prolific, got all these little fruits on there and they're even dropping the ground, there's so many of them. So what Ed does is that he makes these seeds available to you guys. So Ed, what is your website so that people can contact you and get the boot jalokia pepper seeds, dried whole peppers and the powder and also the seeds for this heirloom rare Everglades tomato?
You can go to our website on the localharvest.org and do a search at the farm section for Southern J Ranch. You can hit the store that way, or we have a redirect. If you head in southernjranch.com, it will redirect you to the local harvest store.
All right, great. So you heard it there, southernjranch.com redirects to you to them, so you can get a hold of them, order them seeds. Now he ships all across the country, and he even told me he shipped to the North Pole, and that's North Pole, Alaska, if I have any viewers out there. But in any case, I've had a great time here at the ranch, actually picking up my papayas and sharing all this information with you. Hopefully you've enjoyed it too. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and keep on growing.